Well, I guess what I should say is that my double first cousin, Tony, Anthony Duke, and I are the two oldest members of the Benjamin Duke family. That's hard to believe, but I guess it's true. We just lost both my brother and my other first double cousin. There were four of us, and we just lost them in the last few years. So I'm thinking back over those nice years that I had growing up at 1009 Fifth Avenue, and I had really wonderful memories. It was a very normal kind of marvelous childhood that I only have nice memories of. I lived up about fourth floor, and I could look into the faces of those wonderful Madonnas or angels on the stone frieze around the Metropolitan, and I looked at them every day. And I could look down and see the people come in and out of the Met. That's one of the strongest memories I have. And then the nice fireplaces and the fire always in the winter. We had fires in all of the fireplaces. And I even remember, I can't say how old I was, I'm sure I have it down somewhere, but my brother and I were christened in the library. And for some odd reason, I remember that it was a very cold day and the fireplace comes back to me very clearly. In those days, people didn't eat as much together as, for instance, we do now. We just sit around a table, everybody together. But then we ate quite early. But I remember that was in the dining room, and I enjoyed those wonderful canvases on the wall, those flowered circles. They were just kind of wonderful ovals on the wall. Perhaps I should say something about the fact that my mother just loved interior decoration. And she was a real authority on French furniture. She loved it, and she was interested in doing things to 1009 that would bring it up into, Beaux-Arts feeling. And her relationship was wonderful with a very fine Swiss-German, Karl Bach, who was a New York decorator. And he was extremely fond of her, and he would come in from White Plains, and they would talk over the new things that she wanted to do to the house. So it showed her caring about that house. She loved it, and she really was always upgrading something, changing, fixing, moldings, and everything like that was important to her. One thing I think is important about the location of the house, and that always meant a lot to us, is that it's right in the center of everything. Of course, we went to the Metropolitan Museum all the time, and we had music lessons and ice skating lessons and all that, but we didn't have to go very far for it because it was right there in the middle of it. After my mother died, my husband said, maybe we could buy the house back from the estate and you could be responsible for keeping the look of that neighborhood and the house. And we talked about it a long time, but we did it. And I've been so happy that we did it, because without landmarking and without ownership and so on, I mean, there were plans for putting an apartment house up there, so I'm afraid it would have been gone. It's terribly important that the house doesn't need to be redone on the outside. Our son became inspired with the fact that the roof needed redoing. We needed to develop something that was within Landmark's decision making. We just realized that people had to care. And so that is when James put together the outside, and we could say, you know, this house looks the way it did when it was put up. Even the brick was uncovered. It had been painted over. It's proper to keep beautiful architecture. There's little enough of it left. I think it was a perfect place for the family because my father didn't have far to go to work, and she was right in the middle of everything. And you step out on the street, 82nd Street, which is a beautiful street as well, and a wonderful neighborhood. And you'd see the bustling of the Metropolitan, and behind it, the park. Every day of my life when I was growing up, I went skating in the park. That was the thing that we all did and enjoyed thoroughly. It was a perfectly gorgeous neighborhood, and still is. That's the nice thing. It's now called Museum Mile because there are so many museums all the way up. But thank goodness it was Landmark. That's what we wanted to do. And our son, thank goodness, captured the feeling and the spirit of the importance of that. And he determined, by all of the work that he had done on it, fixing the roof and doing the finials and redoing the bow window and all the various things you have to do to a house, taking the proper steps to have the brick restored to the original look, so that now it really looks like a house that you might see in Paris. I've often thought about that. You just you could exchange it with a house in Paris, and yet you're right in the middle of New York. Actually, it's funny to think about with 7 children and 16 grandchildren and 26 great-grandchildren, not any one of us lives anywhere near New York. And you think about it, and I don't think any of them, they're all settled and very nicely all across the United States, and none of them even in a surrounding state. So, you know, the house will not mean and would not mean to any of them what it meant to us, because they've had really almost no connection with it, which is rather sad, but it's just one of those things that you have to face in life.
It was just one of those things, just one of those craziest flings, one of those bells that now and then rings, just one of those things. It was just one of those nights, just one of those fabulous flights, a trip to the moon on gossamer wings, just one of those things.
It's a wonderful place. I just hope that whomever might move into this house enjoys it as much as we did and had to have wonderful experiences that they can look back on. It's been a joy, and I wish everyone who participates in the life of the house that kind of joy.
It was just one of those.